So what happened? The market change also will make the system deployment. Do you accept that again? I remember I implemented one requirement change. I shared with you. As a junior, like you guys are after you graduate, the first project given to you will be normally a small project. So like myself, when I was like, you know, accepted my first job, after went through 1 week training, the first task given to me, I need to go and modify the system. Okay? I was handling vehicle insurance policy registration system. So they wanted to introduce a new vehicle policy, which is crane. You know crane? All the while they handle all kind of vehicle, but no crane. You know what is crane, right? Carry heavy things. Like, you know, construction, all they use crane. So the company requested to add a new product into their product list, which is crane policy. So they have to add that into the COCO box. When you know it's an agent system, an agent system. So agent, now that if you have a vehicle, got to register a policy, insurance policy, you can approach the agent and the agent will use the system to register a new policy for you. It's an agent system, not a customer system. So what happened? They request me to add that one product, the new product, which is the crane. Just a crane, which I did. And then another function, I have to go and modify the formula. For crane, I need to create a new formula, what function? Calculation of the policy amount is slightly different from other vehicles like car or van or lorry. Crane is something very huge, right? So the policy formula calculation for the payment is slightly different. So I need to go and add that. I already have all the requirement in my hand. You know, I just took about 1 to 2 hours because I was writing the document for so many days. So when I was given the project, I quickly implemented within a few hours. You know how much my company charged for that few hours work? Can you imagine how much? $8,000. Which I just, a junior company within 2 hours or 3 hours, they charged the company $8,000 plus. The change request, when I saw the form, wow. The one I did the other day, 2 hours, $8,000, but a few years back. Now, I'm being more, you know. This is when my first job, 25 years old, 24 years old. How many years back? 16 years back. So can you imagine, it was 8,000, a junior did a small change on the system, cost 8,000. See, change is really most welcome by the company. You know why? They can earn a lot of money through the change, not through the system development. New system development not ready. But when every time they maintain the system, they earn a lot. But do you think when your company, your customer, your client approach you, request for a change, as a vendor, as a developer, you straight away accept and wait for them? Do you do that? That's important. Do you do that as a good developer, okay, ethical developer? Do you straight away accept the change? You shouldn't do that. You know what? Sometimes the change request can be so burdening. It will increase the cost, like, you know, like that's not worth to do it. Sometimes not really necessary, but they don't understand the client, they don't know their side, they don't really see the overall picture. So as a developer, it's your responsibility to always, when you get a proposal, right, you analyze. You analyze the change, see whether it's really recommended or not. If not recommended, you reject. If it's really good, worth for the money, really needed for the company, then you accept. So you see, these are the change requests, okay, status. Can you understand? So you draw a stick chart diagram, these are the status. Proposed, rejected, accepted, completed. Understand? Okay, so what you do? When you receive a change request, you analyze whether the change specification is really needed or not. Change analysis and costing, you do the budgeting, costing. Okay? What are the parts, what are the modules going to change? It seems like one change only, but it will affect sometimes so many other modules, you know, because dependency. So you have to analyze whether the change is going to be a major change or minor change, how many parts affected, all that, then you do the costing. Then you see whether They, customer, who is the customer? Requester, who, which position request for the change? Okay, the product including the version, which product currently you would like to change? Okay, description of change request, the very brief explanation, signature, status and comments. Comments are usually after you analyze. Okay? Okay. Okay, find the dependent requirement and the traceability information. download the form, you can fill out the form directly with the application, your company system. So if your client is a member of your system, they can directly go and get a form, request change directly. Okay? That's electronic form, a database to store all the files. Your source code, your requirement document, your test case, your what you call the acceptance test, everything you can store nicely in your database. When you store nicely, your traceability will become super duper easy. When you don't have proper storing or storage, you die. When requirement change, you're going to struggle a lot. Okay? Then electronic transfer, transfer of the form from one department to another department to get an approval or whatever. Mail send up, usually email and all that. Okay? Then electronic signature, you can also update the electronic signature, also more physical. Then discussion forum. So you can go and discuss as in the forum, no need to have face to face meetup. Okay? All these are some of the tools available. Okay? Impact.
Okay?
In the earlier version, the 1.2 called traceability. This is known as traceability. So you see the sentence here. If the origin, this is the origin of class. This is origin. Okay, this is origin. Okay? Of each, its requirement is clear and facilitates the referencing. So if I want, I can refer back to this. If I want, I can refer back to this. This is called references. If this is clear in your company, then you are lucky enough. When you work, you don't go through so much of stress. Consider not. Otherwise, you die. My company, thank God, they keep track of the first company I work. They kept track of everything so clearly. So for me as a student, like you know, first class or not student but fresh grad, I find it quite easy to follow up. Okay, not bad. Okay, to be honest, not bad. I managed to work, I'll catch up very fast. Okay, so traceability is essential assistance in understanding the relationship, okay, that exists within the requirements. So you can see within the same requirement in earlier stages or within this current stage, current version with other components, the relationship improves. Okay, so requirements cannot be managed effectively without traceability. If you don't know who changed the requirement, you know how we made it last time, my company, I told you where the module I changed. They were so nice, you know, in the code, the function, okay, when I added a new function, you know what I did. Okay, of course, I know I won't be working there for so long my lifetime. I will be leaving. Another junior or another engineer will take over my job. What I want. So, to make his or her life easier, you know what I mean? Okay, creator. This is the function I added. So, I put what you know. Creator or blah blah blah. For which version? For version, the changes under blah blah blah, change request number. I put the change request. This is my comment, my code. So, whoever taking over the job in future when I left, they won't be so stressful. They can find this function added in which version. This one done by who is unknown. Okay, added to event. Request from which change request can change back. You understand now? This is systematic way of doing the changes. You understand now? So that's what I meant here. That is all comes under traceability. Okay? Okay, benefit of traceability. These are the benefits. Also might come out in exam. Why traceability is important? The exam president can ask you to explain. They will give you a project scenario explaining about a change request approaching your company. Okay? And maybe problem, maybe they are facing some problem. So, maybe because they don't have traceability, proper traceability. So the question might ask you, what are the importance of traceability? And write any point relevant to the scenario. So the first point here, okay, prevent losing knowledge. Yeah. Let's say this version you don't keep the record. Do you have the knowledge of your first version? Do you still have the knowledge? No, you are losing the knowledge. Correct or not? So that's the meaning. Impact analysis. Yeah. What is the impact when I change one requirement? For example, when I change this one, you see, when I change this one requirement, I can see the impact on what? The impact on what? So the impact is big or small? How many requirements affected? You understand or not? So that is the impact. You can analyze the impact. Support the verification process, certification, localization are easy for you to get the approval. Okay, then change control. You can control the change. If let's say one change affects all the parts, do you go with the change? You can tell them, hey, I changed this much component now. Like you are changing the whole system. No. So you can control the change. You understand one. If processing, process monitoring, you can monitor the process, improve software quality by having a good traceability, quality always, okay, guarantee. Re-engineering, you know what is re-engineering, right? Reverse engineering or what you call that, re-engineering all possible. Reuse also easier for you. When you want to reuse the component, you want to reuse this unit, you know, okay, I need this whole thing. So reusability will be easier. Okay, and then finally, risk reduction, obviously. Okay, you can reduce the risk by planning, okay, whether this change is possible to implement, can increase the cost, can increase the schedule. So risk can be analyzed. Okay? Okay, here I have some points. Also, my cover in exam. This traceability topic is quite popular. Okay, so huge amount of requirement traceability are very difficult. This one I just show you one component or one module. Imagine your system got 30 modules. Your system got 10 subsystem. Oh, die. Can you imagine how complicated the requirement now look like? Okay, so manual creation of the thing is very, very demanding. Okay, specialized tools must be used. Well, tools not easy to find. You cannot find one tool which satisfy your expectation. Very difficult to find traceability tool which is ready. Okay, can help you in everything. Okay, during the change. So sometimes, even though you have the tool, you still need to manage. That's the problem. Okay, integrated heterogeneous model information. Okay, you know what is homogeneous and heterogeneous? Homogeneous means same type. Okay, requirement and requirement. Heterogeneous means, genius means requirement and design. Requirement and source code. That one is very challenging. Okay, finally, requires organizational commitment. Okay, you have to assign someone to take care, take charge of traceability. You cannot simply let the traceability to just purchase the tool and you don't bother, it will mess up. So you need to have someone in charge and you can take care of this requirement. Okay? So it's quite complicated. Okay, this is an example of traceability class. Okay, source code, test data, user manual and requirement. You need to find heterogeneous means between different type how to trace. Within the same type, homogeneous. Clear? Okay? So this is an example. So forward and backward, you all know, right? You are aware of forward. What is forward? What is backward, class? What is forward? What is backward? Very easy to remember. Class, which one you come out with first? Requirement? Document. After requirement document, you come out with design. Then after design document, you come out with source code. Okay with me? Then after that, you have your test case. Test, blah, blah, blah. Right? Agree with me? And then lastly, user manual. Agree with me? Okay, from here, if you trace this backward or forward? Logic. Which is at the back? Which is at the back? This is back. So you are going? You're going backward or you're going forward? So forward traceability. If from the requirement document you're trying to find the source code, backward traceability. Understand, ma'am? If you try to go and find the earlier stage resources, you're going forward traceability. If you try to find the next, backward traceability. Okay?
Yeah.
we do like this. Okay. So now we have employment and designer. So we have this two. Okay, we have this two. Forward means, what is the meaning? Forward. From here, go to the next one. Correct. From here, go to the next one. So that's why forward two means I'm moving to the next one. Two means going. So going to the next one. So the meaning is I'm going from the requirement to the design. So the direction is from requirement to the design. Requirement. Forward to, forward from. Okay. Now let's say requirement document. We are only studying the requirement document. I think I used the requirement document to explain to you. Otherwise, you will get confused. Very simple. To means, from means what? Okay, to means to the requirement document. To the requirement document. From means from the requirement document. So this is to, this is from. Okay? Yeah. This is how I usually explain. Easy to remember. Okay, requirement document, to requirement document, from requirement document. So now forward. Forward means next step. Correct one, next step. So forward to. Forward to means what is here? What is here? Who can tell me? Before requirement, what is the? What do you call it?
Precedent.
Yeah, what is precedent document? The previous one. All the interview, observation, whatever documents you have, like organization background, all that are known as this document. Okay. That's why forward to is from here to here. Understand or not? Forward from means forward from. So from requirement document. Forward from requirement document. So what do you go with? Design. Agree? So requirement to design is forward from.
Okay, type of traceability.
trace. What do we trace? We can trace the source. We can trace the rationale. We can trace the requirements. We can trace the architecture. We can trace the design. Source code also can do. Source code. Okay? Interface. Source code. Code. Test case. Test the plan ability of features, functions. We can trace a lot of things with the traceability.
If one depends on three, if I depend on you,
Okay. Last few slides are measurement metrics and scalability. Okay, measurement metrics are straight away to show you the data. There are two categories here. Before I forget, there are two categories. One is development, this is product, the other one is quality, not project. Product comes from in product and quality. We see typo.
All comes under requirement management. Even risk 应该吧，我们已经是准备是回家。
Next Monday, have a few questions.